Good evening and welcome to Ending the Day with God on Tuesday the 3rd of October. We opened this evening with a piece of music by Paul Miller called O Vos Omnes. And so we pray. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. The Lord is the strength of my life. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. This evening's reading and reflection see us starting a new focus, and we are looking at the third and fourth chapters of St. John's Gospel. The theme this evening is the known unknown, and our reading comes from chapter 3. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus said to him, "How can these things be?" Jesus answered him, "Are you the teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony." Thanks be to God. And now to our reflection. The realm of the Spirit is a mysterious realm, completely unlike the familiar realm of the flesh. How can we even begin to understand it? Jesus gives Nicodemus the simplest of images to contemplate, the sound of the wind. The association of God's Spirit with wind goes back to the very opening of the Bible, with God's wind sweeping over the surface of the waters in the very first chapter of the book of Genesis. Jesus, however, personifies the wind, giving it the choice over where it blows. This turns a simple image into something mysterious, suggesting that we are always catching up on how the Spirit has already chosen to act. We only hear the echo of an ever-gusting Spirit. Yet this Spirit need not remain remote from our human being. It is possible to come to know the drama of the wind inwardly, but not without being completely remade, born again. Being reborn means a completely new beginning, a reconfiguring of our hard drive by the working of the Spirit. Nicodemus really does not understand, and Jesus, who has been seeking to reveal the truth to Nicodemus, is naturally disappointed with a teacher who will not learn. All Jesus can do is solemnly assure Nicodemus that he knows these truths firsthand under the impulse of the Spirit. It is the Spirit who is causing him to speak as boldly and directly as he does. As those born of the Spirit, we too will speak boldly of what we inwardly know, though we should be careful not to claim too much for ourselves. It is easy to swap what the ever-free Spirit chooses to do through us and what we might have an inkling of knowing for an idol of our own imagination. Amen. Now we come to our prayers for the world and the people amongst whom we live. Father, we pray through your Spirit for a world which is bleeding and aching, fighting and starving, cruel and vulnerable. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we pray through your Spirit for the hurting and hating, for the damaged and the deluded, for the ruthless and the wretched. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we pray through your Spirit for all those we love and cherish, and for those we work at loving. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, through your Spirit, we thank you for the flow of your love, which fills our lives with colour and joy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now, let us pray the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, thine unworthy servants, do give thee most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life. But above all, for thine inestimable love, in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace, and for the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honour and glory, world without end. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.